Hello, I'm Daniel Young from Markforged. This is part two of a three-part series on the anatomy of 3D printed parts. We'll be talking about walls and supports. Walls are the outer boundary of each printed layer. Together, they form the outer shell of the part not contained by the floor or roof. Unlike conventional walls used in building construction, 3D printed shells aren't strictly vertical. Contours and curved surfaces are actually composed of walls printed slightly offset from the previous layer. Walls are printed at a set bead width, which is determined by the nozzle. Markforged walls are two 400 micron beads for a total thickness of 800 microns, but can be increased if needed. Wall thickness dictates how much material you can remove while post-processing printed parts. Thicker walls also grant greater wear resistance because there's more material to wear through before reaching the infill. On thin geometries, parts should be designed to even multiples of the bead width to ensure walls print correctly. Support material is a sacrificial scaffold printed to support areas of the part that are cantilevered or bridged from the main structure. Typically, supports are printed using the same material as the part and are peeled away, though some machines can print soluble supports using a secondary material. Supports trigger at different angles depending on the material, but usually start on faces about 45 degrees from vertical. That's the basics of walls and supports. To learn more about 3D printed parts, check out markforged.com. Happy printing!